the city of Brest, its naval base, marina, military vessels, and nuclear submarines. Brest was almost entirely rebuilt in the 50s. Obviously, the concrete architecture isn't the best ambassador for the city. Nevertheless, I wish I could spend more time here to go for a stroll through the very lively marketplace. There is a French saying that goes, "You don't come to Brest by chance, you must have a pretty good reason to go there." Personally, this is a new stage in my Tour de France of tramways. Actually, there used to be a tramway in Brest from 1898 to 1944. After the war, till the 70s, it had been replaced by trolleybuses. The tramway has been back since 2012 and I'm ready to take a ride. Let's check out what the new tramway brings to the city. Firstly, I must admit that I'm seduced by the green color of the rolling stock. It brings a dash of fantasy to the graying streets of Brest. On the contrary, I'm not fond of the onboard recorded announcements. You have to endure them before each stop in French, English and Breton. This is the most talkative tram I've ever been on! Secondly, you know what? This tramway is being very well taken care of. Look at the specific lawn mower. It shows no mercy for the slightest blade of grass. At this stop, high pressure cleaning is being done to restore the shine of the very first days. Nevertheless, I'm still perplexed regarding the way the stations are decorated. Was it really necessary to fix those random words to the street lamps? Most of the 14 kilometers route is the same as the old tramway line. Some of the old world mounting devices of the former overhead power line are still visible on certain house fronts. The Citadis rolling stock doesn't seem affected by the steep slopes of the streets of Brest. And now, here is the great moment of the journey. We are now crossing the Pont de Recouvrance. This not very gracious bridge is indispensable to cross over the military base. Its enormous emblematic concrete towers have been looming here since 1954. They house the machinery that enables the bridge deck to be lifted. In 2011, huge roadworks were done to adapt the bridge to the tracks of the new tramway and its overhead power lines. So, what the next stage for the tramway network? Let's find out around the town hall square. Some railway junctions have already been made here. I guess they will be used when Line B is running. Its future route could replace the current Line 1 bus service. That would be the occasion to get rid of those polluting vehicles. Waiting for the great opening day of Line B, I must admit that I'm totally convinced by the comeback of the tramway in Brest. It fits perfectly with the city's scenery, as if the old transport tradition here has hoisted the sail of modernity.